Alrighty. Welcome to case number one of our 15-case 2016 Bowman Player Break, hosted on blowoutcards.com. This is a hobby case. I'm going to show you the case. And we'll get started. Hold on. How do I forget my knife? I fully expect this to be the most epic break ever, with as many issues as I had this afternoon. A full 40 minutes of delays. Make sure there ain't no issues in the thread. Oh, okay, good. I know, right? I'm just trying to adjust my screens. Usually everything's set up for me with Ustream. Just making sure I'm not having any issues whatsoever, because I don't want issues whatsoever. Good. I'm glad. All right, box one. I am going to try to do at least two cases tonight. That is about all I can promise, because I did not take any time off of work. So, I was so busy worried about the internet connection, I haven't really got set up on the other details that I need to have set up. I think I'm okay though. Yeah, I wish they were all jumbos. I actually am going to see if they'll let me do an all jumbo. A Mad Rosario purple paper. An all jumbo break, but I'm supposed to wait a week until I hear if I can post another one of these. Right now they don't have the quantity, but who knows. Hell, I'd love to do 20 cases, because if I could get, I think that's pretty much the last of it. Or so they say. We got a gold turn two. Non-auto. Stevenson and Stevenson. 43 of 50. It all comes in waves. I've been saying that since everybody said my Kata was short printed. I realize he's a little short printed, but I don't think he's as short printed as people think. How's everything on the stream? Is it okay? Y'all know I'm gonna ask that at least 20 times tonight because I'm don't want any issues. Awesome. Not a lot of lag. Good. Thanks, fellas. I know, what, Ortiz hit his fourth home run yesterday or something like that? Green Shimmer coming. Luke Weaver, Green Shimmer. 23 of 99. This stuff dropped big time. There for a while. I might have to talk to you about a few base autos one day, Paul. I don't have anything of them. I know you're all about that Kohler. Glasnow and Meadows. Now let me know. They don't have to be gem mint for me to buy them, as long as they're in decent condition. Sunny gray paper. What's up, Steve? Didn't you already say what's up? Hey, Roger. I might have missed it. It's going. Paul, are you messing with me now? Are you guys messing with me? Yeah, don't do that after I've had internet issues all afternoon. You know, I had a heart attack like 2 years ago. I don't want to have another one. First auto, I pull them like it's my job. Acevedo, refractor auto. Thank you. Oh, I meant to tell you, Doug, I saw your signature on Blowout. I love that. It is very true. Soroka, purple paper. Bo Burrows refractor. Bregman top 100. Up. Here comes my little boy. I hear him running through the house. What's up, buddy? You have fun at school today?
He's in underwear all day.
Oh, big boy. Give me five. That's right. Missed you. Hayward, purple paper. Did you lose a lot of sleep over if you were going to hit a red or not? Yeah, the Ortiz Super's been pulled. Why haven't you bought that yet, Paul? That's probably not bad if he's going to be as good as you think he is. What if he ends up the next Ryan Howard? You'll regret not paying that. With every home run, the price goes up. Did you buy Lucius Fox? Oh, okay. Purple auto. Rafael Bautista for the Nationals. 48 of 250. I definitely think the chat's more lively on Breakers. So after watching the Ustream, after watching the Futures game, how many of y'all are stocking up on Ryan Stanek? That dude has such a terrible attitude. I don't enjoy watching someone fail much, but that guy enjoyed watching fail. Hated him in college. I enjoyed every living moment of it. Straight garbage. Every pitch was straight. That hit, that home run that Jimenez hit was unreal. That ball was smashed. He's going to hit one over that building one day in a home run derby. Big Fred looked good. Coulomb refractor. Did you see somebody hit the red inceptionized Jalen Ortiz on the boards, Paul? Okay. Well, everybody bid it up for Paul. I'm messing with you. Gold paper, Blandino. 27 of 50. That was a pretty nice looking card. Orange. Mike Clevinger. It's not a bad one. 7 of 25. Second. Yeah, I've only bought a couple of guys in Inception. Mateo, because he's just dirt cheap. Yadier Alvarez for the Dodgers. That's his first auto. Old Bowman auto. And Gleyber Torres. Haps a stud. Saw a refractor auto 9/5/10 sold for like $120 the other day. Hey, I'll take them. He is absolutely crushing the ball right now. The Cubs are drafting the perfect people for their organization. But does he have a position when he gets to Chicago? Greg Bird, refractor auto. I've got a lot of his stuff. I should have been buying more when his autos dipped to like 17 and 18 bucks pop. I hope not. Who do they have at second right now? Mazzara, top 100. The only trade bait to me would be Torres. Yeah, the Zobrist can play anywhere. Oh, recruiting? Or what do you mean, like, how do I research players that I go after? Or what sites that I work for with recruiting? Most of the time, I just use YouTube and watch video. The one thing I'll always say is that you can watch video. You can read what somebody says about a prospect all day long, but they might be invested in some way in that prospect. I mean, a lot of these guys that work for Baseball America, ESPN, I've heard Keith Law was a baseball card collector. I mean, they have some kind of input into what those guys are valued at by doing that. But the one thing that will never lie or ever have any kind of, what I'm saying is, I don't really know the word I'm looking for, but the only thing that will never lie is video. You see video and you watch your prospect, I mean, more than once, you can usually see what you need to see from those guys. The special ones always stand out. Compact. Yeah, see, I wouldn't agree with that. I like J.P. Crawford, but there are better shortstops. Prospects, like all-around prospects. And on it, well, yeah. I mean, Moncada and Bregman are definitely up there. I say potentially someone like Glasnow could be in the top two or three. I just think his stuff is that good. I don't think Giolito is that on that level. To me, Glasnow is a future Cy Young guy. Nick Williams, purple. Multiple Cy Youngs. Yeah, but you look at shortstops, you cannot tell me that like on Baseball America, what was it? Trey Turner was ranked ahead of Swanson and Bregman and Mateo and all these other guys. I'm like, really? Can you honestly think that that's even accurate? Orlando Arcia, too. Who, Nick Williams? Wow. Oh, look, Super Fractor. And that's a bat that I see. You see that bat? I don't know who that is, but let's see. Holy crap. Steve-O. Victor Robles Super Fractor. Steve. Monster hit. I thought this was already pulled. Look at that. Look at that, man. That is awesome. That is awesome. Congrats, buddy. Let me get a top loader. That is awesome. Where did I put my top loaders? All right, let me get a top loader real quick. Wow. First case, Super Fractor. Where's my top loaders? Jeez. I'm going to put them in a different kind of top loader. Oh, wow. That is beautiful. One of one, Victor Robles. That's a nice little $1,000 hit, or close to it one day. Wow, nice, man. Congrats. You know what I'm going to do for right now? Because that's a little bit of a loose top loader, just to make sure that it stays in good condition. I don't want it sliding around. I'll put it in a team bag. There we go. That's awesome. Hell, I should probably tweet that. Let me tweet it real quick. Well, Steve, have to say, this saying's been said a lot, but couldn't happen to a nicer guy. No, sir. I actually, like I said, I thought this card was pulled. I don't know why, but I thought it had been pulled. But that's awesome, man. All right, let's proceed. Was sweet. I saw the bat, and it wasn't even the person I was thinking it was. I knew it wasn't Bregman because Bregman's got the black bat. That's crazy. It's actually the only person it could have been. Yeah, the super auto has been pulled. It got pulled like within the first week. That's why I don't understand why the case prices keep going up. All the big guys have been pulled, besides Bregman. And to me, that isn't a reason to keep having the prices increase. We're not talking about a Chris Bryant. Anfernee Seymour, base auto. Oh yeah, and Anthony Alford. I was going to ask you the other day, Steve-O, whenever I posted, I was thinking about selling Mankata. I was thinking about asking you if you'd trade Swanson and Robles for Mankata, and I was like, no, nah, he probably wouldn't do that. Glad I didn't. I know I've owed you some big color, so there we go. Chris Sale, purple. I would have felt bad if we would have traded and that would have worked done happen. I've seen some of these cases with two supers in it, so we shall see. Well, perfect timing. Yeah, if I was him, I wouldn't even sell it. Not yet. It's the very first card. I wouldn't even consider selling it right now. With a way national, I mean, if I posted it anywhere, it'd be on eBay for a $2,500 and best offer or something like that. Somebody might be crazy enough to hit the bin. If you were selling, but I probably wouldn't. I remember that monster red you hit. I wonder if that guy got it graded. What hit? Robles Superfractor. Oh, yeah. Courtney Hawkins, purple. I probably should have waited to tweet that because my phone's going to start blowing up now. You know how to get a good grade on it if it's borderline? If you live close enough, go to the National and pay for it to be graded right there, or send it in on a 5-day. The faster you get them to look at it and the faster the turnaround, usually the more you pay, the better odds you're going to get of getting a better grade. Just how they are, which is kind of crazy, but still. Oh yeah, I would do it in person then. I would drop it off, pay $60, and let them grade it while you're there. I'd get there on the first day, though, because Saturday and Sunday is nuts. Anytime, same day grading on any high end there, you'll do so much better for yourself. I saw borderline card. I got one guy's card just by cleaning the surface and pressing down some corners. It was a black refractor auto of Austin Meadows. It was a 910. When I got through cleaning it and everything and submitting it on the same day stuff, it came back a 1010. Oh, awesome. Got a redemption. Good luck. I wonder if Joey's watching. Due to receive. Chrome rookie autograph. Well, we know who this is. Blue refractor. Conforto. Who had Conforto? Dallas Stars. Okay. If it's just a little white, I'm telling you, pay the upgrade to get it done fast. And that's a card you definitely want to get graded fast. Orange paper. Nice one for Dave. Heredia. 3 of 25. That time we started seeing some orange. Got a gold refractor. Tukey. 9 of 50. Taking a long time on this first case. First six boxes. Well, super, I'll do that. Paul, are you still in Israel? Okay. Lucius Fox refractor. Arenola blue paper. Who needs sleep, Paul? For real. I wish I had some call-in time. I'd call in tonight and just keep breaking. Actually, I'd just call in for the rest of the week if I had the time. I don't want to call in for just one night. Seems like a waste. Got a sophomore standouts auto, and it's Jock Peterson. That's numbered 83 of 99. Are you really working for Pokemon and Nintendo? That's pretty awesome right now. Okay. I gotcha. Plasma top 100. Yeah, that shit's everywhere right now. So how much has it went up in that month? I'm sure it's doing well. Wow. That's probably a decent amount. Chris Shaw purple. Good Lord. Kolek and Josh Naylor Green, 63 of 99. Turn two with a couple of hits. Wow. That's crazy. Jacoby Jones refractor. Fulmer turn two. Orange paper. Brandon Belt, 6 of 25. But if you get the red, are you going to buy the super? I think you need to get your priorities online. I'd rather own Nintendo. You might have to add in your non-gradable Jalen Ortiz's base autos into that Gleyber Torres thing offer you made. I might be able to pull it off for that. Yeah, you'll never get the JP Super. Never. Wasamata. In fact, you probably would be better served if you went ahead and bought the Super. Because if he ever gets an idea of to go ahead and buy it, it's lost forever. His collection is where cards go to die. Jeff Hoffman Gold for top 100, 23 of 50. And you don't want that, bud. No. He just likes top prospects. And it didn't even have to be good prospects. I remember when Jordan Schaefer stuff took off in like 2007, 2008. You know, when he was hitting the roids pretty good. And I was selling blues to him for like $140 a piece. It was ridiculous. And these were non-auto blues. X-Fractors for like 80. Refractors for 40. I mean, I killed it with him. Ortiz, base auto. On the board, bud. Looks to be in pretty good condition. It's just that bottom right corner. All right. I like to hit you red, not even for that reason. I know you want one. That way you buy the damn super. Hey. That's what I want. Tyler Wade purple. I didn't do any for Blowout when Chris Bryant stuff came out. But I heard that it was going for like around a grand to 1500, but most of the time people wouldn't even sell it. I know when I was running team breaks on eBay, the Cubs were getting, in 2014 Bowman, the Cubs were getting around 250 to 300 in every one of my breaks. Sheffield orange paper. But the funny thing was, is they only went for around 150 in my Bowman Chrome breaks in 2014. And in 15, I only hit, well, get back to the original. The 2016 Bowman, I only hit one Chris Bryant base auto in all those cases, I think. Or throughout all my breaks with that product. In 2014 Bowman Chrome, I hit 12 in 15 cases. They were either base or refractor autos, the 2013 version. So it was pretty much a guarantee at that point. There was a certain case number that I had that were coming in that I was buying. And every time it was these one or two case numbers, it was a guarantee Chris Bryant, believe it or not. Yeah, the autos should be different. Now, I wouldn't be surprised if they put like Mankata refractor autos in there. Or something like they did with Chris Bryant. But I know the early stuff I've seen is Vladimir Guerrero Jr. will be in it, which he's pretty much the headliner. But I've, so far, hopefully they had some more guys. The sell sheet had Adam Engel on it, though. That wasn't very... That wasn't very enticing. Bowman Chrome will be hot if they get the right people in it. But the Maeda won't sell for that much because it's a second card. They'll have some good rookie autos. But they'll have Corey Seager in there again, which is stupid. But he'll have a base chrome this time. I think it'll be a decent product, but I think they have Gleyber Torres as a non-auto, which is exciting to me because he hasn't had a non-auto card yet. He just has the 2015 Chrome Auto and the Inception Auto. For Dave, Anderson Espinosa, Refractor Auto. Well, I wouldn't be surprised if he had another auto. I mean, honestly, I wouldn't be. Topps is doing better this year with listening to customers, but they've still got to stop overproducing and stop putting the same prospects in every freaking product. There's so many Chrome guys out there that don't even have a card. I mean, good prospects that don't even have a card. Tyler White. I mean, everybody knows what happened with his Elite Autos when he got made the Astros out of spring. I mean, his Elite Auto was selling for $100. Now he's in AAA. Yeah, he even made the team out of the spring and didn't even have a chrome auto. Or a base chrome, for that matter. And still doesn't. If I'm not mistaken, I don't even think he's got a card at all. The Silver Elite. Green Shimmer, Carrizales, 2/99. What's up, man? By the way, Robbins, I wanted to tell you, thank you for bumping that thread. That helps to get it filled, and I appreciated it. I was on vacation during all that, the last week or so. Chris Bostic Refractor. Now if you could just push my 2015 Bowman break, that'd be great. Just one super pulled, but box 9. This case is taking a while because of the super. Yeah, I think it was box 3 or 4. Robles super non-auto. Strasburg blue paper. Yep, first case. It's all downhill from there. 13/150. Hell, with as many supers that are out there, I should hit at least one per case of the ones that just haven't been pulled yet. Acevedo base auto. He's on the board with 2 already. Sports guy, Odell. He's got to love me at this point. Bad as I don't think Dale gets on breakers. I think he's always on Ustream. And there is no Ustream today. And won't be probably for the break. After this case, I'm going to take a quick break to go grab me some dinner. Robert Refsnyder, base auto. And then I'll be back with case 2. It won't be that long. Probably about 30 minutes. I think I should be able to get through two cases, but and start to, I might even do a jumbo in the morning, which will be case three, and then start back up tomorrow afternoon. With me not taking any time off of work, it's going to take me a little bit longer than normal to break these cases. But taking time off right now isn't an option. Yes, recap will be posted to YouTube. Or you could just watch it live. Yeah, basically as a rule from Blowout, and pretty much what I've always done is I always post a recap video, do a separate one, because that's pretty much the rules and what people want. Try to make it as easy as possible on you guys to see what all has been hit. 91 of 150, Flaherty blue paper. Love it when I hit my hand on the paper base. Blue, Rowdy Tellez. 110 of 150. So if you subscribe to my YouTube channel, you'll get updates when the videos go live. Or you could just watch the thread and I'll post links in there too. I'll be in the thread and on the first page, as always. What's up? E.J. Stewart refractor. Berrios, turn two. I think that's Berrios and Gordon. Let me see. No, Jay. Hunter Pence, orange paper. Two orange papers of the Giants, Belt and Pence. Save those up for playoffs. Oh, we've hit one orange refractor. Hopefully these last three boxes are loaded with it. Yeah. I know, right? Well, usually the super cases are pretty loaded, so, I mean, I expect to hit some nice stuff. Brent Honeywell Orange, 2 of 25. Pretty much all the top 100s go to one person, Bill, because he's greedy. Isn't that right, Bill? Both sets sell really well on eBay, by the way. Rudy Garan base auto. Yeah. You don't even have to accept best offers on that stuff. They pretty much sell for $125 to $130. Top 100, which is a hard set to put together. I mean, it really is. I wish turn two sold for 100 and something bucks. I've got several of them. Hell, I haven't even looked and seen how much they sell for. I need to finish sorting out all my base and selling those sets. What are the base sets of 2016 Bowman going for? I know they were at like $25 a piece. Delivered. Oh, my bad. It's not a hard set to put together. It's not that many of those cards. Oh, I meant to ask you, Bill. Have you ever been to Taco Boy in Charleston? The one down on Huger Street? Dude, you gotta go. If you like tacos, you gotta go. Specialty tacos, not like normal tacos. It was always been good, but this last week they changed their cook and he is on a different level. Taco Boy. Shroud on Huger Street. Hole in the wall. Real cold beer. Nice margaritas. All that good stuff. Francis Martes. Damn, Steve. Why don't you hoard things up a little bit? Orange Refractor. 13 to 25. Oh, the one in Folly Beach isn't the same. It's not anywhere near as good for some reason. Maybe they changed it. Paul had to take it there. Just had to take it there. Yeah, it's a lot better. You ever go to Andolini's, the pizza place in Mount Pleasant? It's pretty good. We had a good time. Saw a lot of things we haven't seen before. We made sure to make an effort to do that, so that was pretty cool. I got sunburned on the first day so bad that it wasn't even funny. Derek Fisher Refractor. Turn two, Bregman and Cameron. Man, I heard Daniel Island was awesome. I haven't even been there. I need to go. Heard it's a nice place to visit. Dylan Betances. Purple paper. Yeah, I'll have to go. Was it near? Yes, Charleston, SC. Voted the number one place in the world, town in the world to visit. Just recently. That was pretty cool. Seafood. Depends on how much you want to spend. Hyman's is a classic. It's like, you know, the one everybody goes to. Then you got Hank's, who's more upscale and probably the best seared fish. If you go to that restaurant, you got to order something that's seared because Tim Richardson, the chef, he's amazing. But if you want to keep it kind of cheap, you got that. You got Bowen's Island for seafood, but you can split a plate between, I don't know how much you can eat, but Bowen's Island gives you way too much food. You can split it between two people easily. Tons of good restaurants down there. World acclaimed chefs. Sean Brock. What's the other guy? At Fig. Mike Lotta. He's awesome. Crew Cafe is another great one. Marta's Base Auto. Yeah, I could tell you anything you need to know. Just hit me up on Blowout. Vintage Trader is another good one to talk to about it. Oh, and go to any of the beaches early. If you're going to a beach, go early. Otherwise, you're going to have parking issues. And hell, just getting there in general issues. It's getting so crowded down there, it's not even funny. Contreras, top 100. No, I'm not going to the National. I went to the one in Cleveland 2 years ago, and on my plane ride home, started having chest pains, and then had a heart attack the next morning. So, I'm probably going to stay away from the National. Too much partying for me. Yeah, figured I would just stay at home and be a good boy. Francisco Purple. I wouldn't mind going maybe to Baltimore if they have it there. Because I've been promising my wife we need to get up there and visit her brother and all that in Baltimore. Maybe, I would like to visit Chicago. I've always wanted to go to Chicago, but I don't know. We'll see. They need to have one in Atlanta or Orlando. I think that would be awesome. Carson Fulmer, refractor. What part of Georgia are you from? Sophomore standouts, blue paper, Francisco Lindor. Okay, I know what you're talking about. Up in the mountain area. Well, more mountain than anywhere else in Georgia. Used to play in high school basketball tournaments in Chattanooga. I'm about 2.5 hours from Knoxville. Isn't that about the same for Chattanooga? Yeah, I thought so. My wife was just come back not long ago from Nashville. I wouldn't mind getting up there and visiting. She said it's pretty awesome. Says she walked out of a restaurant and walked straight into a Jason Aldean concert, which actually was for CMT. Michael Bradley, purple paper. I'm in Greenville, South Carolina, northwest part of the state, right near Clemson University, that shithole, and Lake Hartwell, which is pretty famous with Bassmaster and all the fishing tours. Got another redemption. Could this be Maeda? Due to receive, Chrome Prospect Autograph, Kenta Maeda. There we go, Joey. For real. Nobody wants that garbage. Except for the guy with that spot. Actually, I don't even think they would want that. $1 in your pocket ain't going to make a difference. The first redemption was a blue Conforto. And last pack, box, case number one. That's it. I'm gonna stop the recording. And I will go eat some dinner. Come back and do the recap and start on case number two, which will be a hobby case as well. All right, Paul, have a good one, man. I'll make sure to pull something while you're not watching, just to make it easy on you.